Hey guys, this is Danielle from So Much Crafting, and I am here today with a quick flip through of our 2020 Christmas kit. Now, we've offered this in the ring version for several years. We added traveler's notebooks a few years ago, and last year was the first year we had it in a spiral bound kit. And I just wanted to flip through and give an updated view of what's inside so that you can see what you would get if you ordered the Christmas kit from So Much Crafting. This is the personal ring size I'm just going to show you. I also have the pocket TN from last year. I might flip through and show you a few pages of actually what I used. We have the ring version, like I said, and then the spiral here. I'll flip through that as well toward the end. So on this first page, we have a countdown to Christmas from 50 days down to Christmas Day. It's in the shape of a Christmas tree. And a lot of people have used little dot stickers, either transparent or colored dot stickers. And you can put those on there. You can do little ornament stickers. You can find stickers, small stickers from Hobby Lobby even, and put those on there. Just a fun way to count down to Christmas. The next two pages are the month on two list. We do offer this in the regular, you know, calendar year, academic year for each month without the little decor. But this is separate in the Christmas kit so that you can mark down special events that you have going on and see them all on one page or, you know, two pages like this. I've also seen people use this for writing down Bible verses that they want to read leading up to Christmas, or maybe write out leading up to Christmas, as well as Elf on the Shelf ideas. So those two pages are there for that. Now the family traditions, I'll go ahead and open that in the one I used last year. This is just little family traditions that we've had. Hanging Christmas lights, we usually do that around the week of Thanksgiving, and then we have a pizza party. We've ordered pizza the last few years. We read the Christmas story on Christmas morning. We like to go see Christmas lights. The last few years, we went to a place in near Oklahoma City. I don't know what we're going to do this year since we've moved to Kansas. But just having those things, I like to look back on that so that I can remember things that we've done as a family. We have three little kids, and just having those family traditions is just a special way to celebrate the holiday season. The next two pages are things to do this year. And again, I'll go ahead and show you what we did last year. This is kind of a bucket list style. You can see we did do several things. You know, honestly, some of these I just never went back and marked off. But some things are picking a tree, decorating the house, hanging Christmas lights, watching certain movies, having hot chocolate, buying a gift for someone, sending Christmas cards, wrapping gifts. These are just things that that our family likes to do. Yes, some of them are traditions, but some of them are just bucket lists, like things that we want to do in the holiday season. Now, the next two pages are dinner plans. You might have dinner with one side of the family and then another, or friends and then family. And there's a place here you can mark the date and time, different dishes that might be prepared. So turkey, ham, rolls, mashed potatoes, things here. Who might be bringing that if it's not you preparing the entire meal? Whether or not it needs to go in the oven. And then two different ideas with this time section. You can either write that the turkey has to cook for 3 hours, or you could write, you know, if you want dinner at 6, you could kind of back it up and see what time you need to put the turkey in order to have dinner at 6. You might write, if you're having dinner at 6, you might write that you want it to go in at 2 o'clock. There's two places here, again, so that you can plan two different dinners. Now, the next two pages are perfect for tracking like a grocery list based off of your dinner plans. So you could write down the things that you need, or you could also keep track of gifts or different things, stocking stuffers, things that you might need to purchase, decoration ideas, things like that. You could put on those two pages. The next place here is travel plans. I like using this in our vacation kit especially, but it's also nice here. If you're traveling somewhere for Christmas this year, you can write where you're going, any contact information. If you're staying in a hotel, or even if it's a family member, you can write down who you're staying with, when you leave, and when you're coming home. Any transportation information, if you have flights or confirmation numbers, you can put there. And then any additional notes you can put down here. Now the next page is a Christmas budget page. You mark here at the top how much you think you're going to spend. You could even fill that in after you've done some of these. And then we went ahead and put in travel, food, and cards and postage so that we don't forget those things. You might have gifts for different people. You could put those here. Again, stocking stuffers, teacher gifts, decorations, things like that. And the way that it's designed is that you would start, if you're going to spend $1,000, you might spend $200 on travel, and then you would have $800 remaining. If you're going to spend $150 on food, then you'd have $650 left, and you just kind of go all the way down until you get to zero. And there's a spot here on the right for the actual amount spent. So at the end of the season, you could go back and write, how much did you actually spend on these things to help you better budget for next year? Now the next two pages are cards to send, and the way that I've used this in the last few years is writing my side of the family here, my husband's side of the family here, and then any family or friends that we want to send that wouldn't necessarily be there, we would write those down here so that we can mark off who we want to send cards to. One thing I do, and I'm not going to show you the card list that I have, but I do look at the last few years and I write down, I'll copy those names from previous years so that I don't accidentally forget anybody. And then again, like I said, friends down here that we would like to send cards to. The next few pages are gift ideas. The first two pages have extra spots, so there's 8 spots for each person. You might use those for your immediate family members. The next two pages have 4 spots per person, and then the last two pages have 2 spots per person. So when I designed these, it was immediate family members, maybe family members or friends, and then this would be like maybe your teachers or church teachers, things like that, that maybe you just get 1 or 2 gifts for, just a place to jot down your ideas, where you might buy it, and then once you've done that, you can check it off. The next page is a stocking stuffer idea page. You can write down the person you're purchasing for, the idea, and then once you've checked it off. The last couple years, what I've done is written my husband's name, and then my daughter, my son, and my other son, and then I've just kind of written down a few things for each person there so that I can kind of divide it out. The next page is a decoration idea page. Maybe you're changing your ornaments on your tree this year, you're changing your decoration ideas, and you just want a place where you can write down maybe where you'd purchase it, what color scheme you're going with, maybe a website that you found inspiration on, and then down here you can do a little sketch. One idea with this is if you're going to do like a mantle, you could draw your mantle and then a couple ideas and write what you're doing there. Or even you could put your room, like if this is your room, you could put your tree here, your mantle here, and just have different things. Maybe you have a bench with some blankets or your couch, just a place to kind of jot down those ideas. And then the last 3 pages are note pages. One there, there, and you flip it, there's the last page, so that maybe you can track just extra notes that you have. Another thing that I've done again with our vacation kit is at the end of our vacation, I go and write down things that worked and didn't work. And you could do that with your Christmas kit as well. Things that did work for the holiday season and things that maybe you would change for next year. You could jot those notes there. And then at the end of the year, what I like to do is take it, and if I use the traveler's notebook, it's already bound. I just put it in an accordion file, or you could take this whole set here and again, slide it into an accordion file, and you can look back at previous years to see what you did or what you would like to change. That was the personal ring size. We also have it in the half letter, the B6 rings, personal wide, A6 rings. This is the first year we're offering it in Pocket and Pocket Plus. So these are all available in the shop now. We also have it in the Pocket TN and the B6 TN. This is the pocket that I've used the last few years. I designed this. It's a sticker. I printed on sticker paper, just this background, wrote the year, and I stuck that to the front of my thing. If that's something you're interested in, either for the B6 or the pocket, or really this other size, let me know and I can upload it on Facebook or put it on our blog and you can grab that. And then this year is the first year we're offering it in the standard TN size. This is 4.25 by 8.25. And again, it's just the same layout, but in a traveler's notebook. I'm not going to go through every single page, but it has the same things. There are a few extra note pages here, I believe, in the back. Just for extra notes. So that's the standard TN, B6, and Pocket TN. This is last year's version for myself. And then this year, we changed the cover, updated the little banner across the front, and this is the spiral that we are offering this year. Again, the same idea. You have your month on two list. You have different things to do this year, Christmas budget. I'm skipping a few pages here. It's all the same as the personal TN or personal rings that I already showed you, but in the spiral version. And then again, some extra note pages here in the very back. Now, all of these are available on our website and in our Etsy shop already. We will be restocking through November so that if you have not purchased it yet, you could go ahead and grab it. As we sell out of different sizes, we would go ahead and restock them. And again, if you like the cover that I've designed for previous years, maybe you want to print that off on sticker paper yourself and stick it to the front of your traveler's notebook. Let me know in the comments below and I will upload that either to our website or to Facebook. I'll throw a link on the video. I'll update the video once I've actually done that. Okay, that is everything in the Christmas kit for this year. Again, we offer in all the ring sizes this year. We're offering it in 3 traveler's notebook sizes and the spiral notebook. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments below and we will talk to you again soon. Bye-bye.